I am every student, and this is a vision of my world, our world, where we have come from, what we have gone through, and where we are going.
This is a journey, not just into our immediate past and present, but all of our possible futures. All of our hopes and fears, our dreams and desires, our knowledge and our ignorance are explored with this one idea in mind. We are every student, and when we leave the comfort of these halls, we will blend in with the rest of the world, and it will be our world. The world will be us.
But who are we? Who were we? After all of these years, we have learned so much. But more importantly, we are not done growing, learning, and becoming.
Don't you think that it's boring how people talk? Making smart with their words again. Well, I'm bored. Because I'm doing this for the thrill of it, killing it, never not chasing a million things I want. And I am only as young as the minute is full of it, getting pumped up on the little bright things I want. But I know they'll never own me.
If you ask us what we've learned in high school, responses will consist of common lessons learned in English, calculus, or biology.
But what we truly have learned goes way beyond what we've read in textbooks.
All of the experiences outside of the classroom have equipped us for the real world.
Desperado with a sour twist. It'll all come sweet on your lips. Cause I'm in love, so old. Put your flowers down, it's too cold. And fuck your romance, I wanna pretend that Jenny Lee Lindberg is my girlfriend. With the sun on my back, it's a nice day.
Thank you. and my niggas tryna get it, yeah bitch.
Yeah bitch.
Hit that house, they tell me is you with it, yeah bitch.
Yeah bitch.
Home invasion was persuasive.
My opinion of myself is worth more than the opinion of others around me.
Back when condom rappers wasn't cool.
There is unity and diversity. Our differences provide the missing links to the chain that connects our humanity.
That burn came on. I saw all that night, I rhyming, yeah bitch.
Yeah bitch.
Park the car, then we start rhyming, yeah bitch.
Yeah bitch.
The only thing we had to free our mind.
Free our mind.
Then freeze that verse when we see dollar signs.
See dollar signs.
You looking like an easy come up, yeah bitch.
Yeah bitch.
A silver spoon, I know you come from, yeah bitch.
Yeah bitch.
And that's a lifestyle that we never knew.
We never knew.
Go at a revenue for the revenue.
We are not limited by the expectations of the people around us. We can achieve any goal if we put our mind to it.
Everybody go respect the shooter, but the one in front of the gun lives forever.
The one in front of the gun forever.
And I've been hustling all day, this away, that away.
Our time is limited, and we must work to make every second count.
Standardized tests are not measurements of our worth and intelligence, but how we deal with the trials of life determines our value and sets us on the path to wisdom.
There are people who will love the parts of us that we hate.
I learned to drive, and you told me you'll never survive. Grab your mother's keys, we're leaving.
Growing up means realizing what things don't work for us anymore and changing them into a new story.
That one day we'd be fighting on a suburban wall.
We can learn more by listening to each other rather than by shouting at each other.
But high school only shows us a glimpse of what the real world is like.
Breaking news in New York City, what's happened in Ferguson.
The racist police department. Violence in Baltimore, who was shot and killed by a police officer. Scenes of chaos.
Okay, what is your experience in being deaf?
It was a lot. A lot of experience.
DHS, I started off with like a lot of friends, and little by little, the more I got to know everyone, like I didn't have as intimate relationships with them, but I think that the more you network and the more you get to know people, you can just get better. I can't think of what I was going to
say. What did you learn in high school? Okay, wait, tell me what would you do?
What's up? Wait, the bell rings.
Deep-fry everything, right? Raise your hand if you think that we should deep-fry everything. One. Two.
My idea of an ideal world for me and for you would be a world where people can just be and be accepted and work towards individual happiness. I think sometimes outside pressures, whether it's family or internal pressures from what you think you're supposed to do, we make decisions that impact our happiness. And so an ideal world is where we're comfortable in our own skin, we're working towards success and happiness, and we the individual, are able to define what that success is for us.
Anybody else's feelings, like, just as long as they're getting what they want, that's all that matters. And I also feel like a lot of people are ignorant to what's going on in the world, and including myself. But I mean, I feel like that should, like, things that are going on in the world, like Kim Jong-un, or like, you know, the war against sexes and all that, I feel like a lot of people need to be more aware of what's going on and change that.
The world is a complicated place, and so I think we often look at how we can impact the world for the better. And, you know, something that I've come to learn, I certainly didn't know this until recently, is that individual steps lead to the successful completion of the long journey. And by that I mean it's more successful to have smaller conversations over long periods of time that lead to change. Often change, when it's sudden and drastic, that change doesn't work. When it's agreed upon, when there's a need that has been communicated and strategies that have been worked out, that change, I think, has proven to be more successful. The attitude that I bring to my job and my life and my family, I try to have a positive attitude, and that counters the negativity that will come. Life brings negative things, loss and sadness and frustration, and so when we can assess what we have and what we're working to and take out the positives and really focus on it, you know, without being corny, you know, just, you know, be thankful. But the truth of the matter is, that's what makes people successful, is being able to work through difficulties and being happy for what you have and working within the parameters of the minute. It doesn't do us any good to say, if only I had $1 million or the better job. It's what are we doing to get to what would that joy, you know, be. I think that's how, you know, you can change the world, taking each situation individually and working towards being a better person in that moment.
We live in a world where we are natural creators, but also natural destroyers. We shape and break the things we touch based on the choices we make. These choices are driven not only by materialistic ideas, but passions and desires.
Ironically, it is human passion and desire that has helped to create a beautiful world as well. Unfortunately, this world is still divided by ideas about race, class, and gender, which come out of closed-mindedness and prejudgment.
This prejudice and willful ignorance keeps us from realizing our true potential and defining ourselves both individually and communally.
However, we tend to forget the beautiful things we encounter every single day.
Besides the evil and chaos we are surrounded by,
We also live in a world where we are free to be one with nature and explore life beyond our own.
We live in a world where love exists. We live in a world where there is evil, but there is also good.
It's easier to look at what's wrong than to appreciate what's right. We are the leaders of the next generation. It is our responsibility to teach happiness and love rather than hate and negativity.
To change the mindset of the youth would be an accomplishment greater than no other. Our children should grow up in a world they believe is magical and beautiful. Our hope is that when we ask our children what kind of world they live in, their response will be filled with positive thoughts about all that is precious about our world.
I want to live in a world where everyone cherishes the simplest pleasures of life.
Where the idea of true happiness is defined as something we can only manifest within ourselves.
Where the ignorance of others does not affect basic human rights.
Where risks are taken. Where we can take the plunge into the darkness of uncertainty with a smile on our face.
Speak up.
Where we don't use others for our own benefit.
Where people aren't hypocritical.
Where practicing compassion is a part of everyone's daily life.
Where we understand and accept the consequences of our actions.
Where ignorance isn't bliss and people actually open their eyes to the world and issues surrounding them.
Where you're judged in character and not on your salary.
Where peace, tolerance, and justice exist together.
Where we can learn what we want to learn without fear or judgment or repercussion.
But how will we make that ideal world a reality? What will we do to make sure that our story isn't just a hopeless sense?
I will understand myself, my weaknesses, and my strengths.
I will be honest with myself and others.
I will learn how to handle the consequences of my decisions.
I will strive for happiness.
I will love deeply and dance like crazy.
I will make the most out of the life I was given.
determination and passion drive me to accomplish my goals.
I will share my knowledge.
I will be brave, even though it might be hard.
I will practice what I preach.
I won't make assumptions.
I will question my actions.
I will change my lens, try another perspective.
I will be compassionate and open-minded, and I will never stop learning.
Loving can hurt. Loving can hurt sometimes. But it's the only thing that I know. When it gets hard, you know it can get hard sometimes. It is the only thing that makes us feel alive. We keep this love in a photograph. We make these memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closing, hearts are never broken, and time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet. You won't ever be alone. Wait for me to come home.
Life is a series of starts and stops. We will face much strife and endure hardships, and we will fall flat on our face time and time again. For all our struggles and failure, never regret. Never falter when reaching for the unattainable heights we seek.
John Green wrote, "When adults say teenagers think they're invincible, with that sly, stupid smile on their faces, they don't know how right they are. We need never be hopeless because we can never be irreparably broken. We think that we're invincible because we are. We cannot be born and we cannot die. Like all energy, we can only change shapes and sizes and manifestations. They forget that when they get old. They get scared of losing and failing. But that part of us, greater than the sum of our parts, cannot begin and cannot end. And so it cannot fail. We are invincible. We must never forget that."
Time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet. Through the phone, wait for me to come home.
remain present in every moment, no matter how common they occur.
Acknowledge the beauty in nature as the seasons change. Find the beauty in solidarity. Take comfort in the fact that what you're feeling has been felt before.
Sing the songs that make you feel something. Don't take these moments for granted, not for 1 second. They are all you have.
Live your life every day, feeling alive.
All these precious moments you promised me would come in time. So where was I when I missed mine?
Bits and pieces of the past 4 years will come back to us as flashbacks, as faraway memories. But the strengths that we have gained will always be a part of us.
We will get settled into a life of our own, start a career, fall in love, and we will only remember faint details of high school.
We've experienced many firsts, from our first heartbreak and failure to our first love and accomplishments. And as difficult as some of those times were, we will be forever grateful for every experience, every individual that has made us who we are.
Of my eyes on the razor swaying from her own clothesline. Like a row of cashiered grocery golden grass was never washed but we've made their clothes. Welcome home.
The most significant lesson I learned in high school is that we're never done growing and becoming.
We walk into these brand new halls as freshmen, expecting that we are going to spend the next 4 years finding ourselves. But as our senior year comes to an end, we come to the realization that we will never really be done finding ourselves.
Helped us shape our identities, but it was only a tiny portion of who we are and who we shall become. We were every student, and now.
Thank you.
let's pretend it grow. Like a ride, like a ride, oh. Not easily offended, not hard to let it go. From a mess to the masses. See it grow.